Today I'm gonna show you my favorite way to tape. Right off the bat, I'm gonna show you my favorite way. I've got a lot of other windows that I'm gonna show you other ways how to mask. This is my favorite. So you wanna tack your corners down. Pull the plastic up and cut it so you don't cut the part underneath it. So now you got these corners tacked down, and now you just want to do a border across it. When you do this border, you want to pull this plastic away, put your hand on the panel so you don't cut your rubber, and you don't want to cut too far in because you're going to be putting a border right on the very outer edge and taping that down. And you don't want it too far in because then you have to use more masking tape. Get your masking tape out. When you mask, you want it right on the edge, but you don't want it sitting on the panel or on the panel that you're painting. You want it just right off of it, right to the inside. You can pull your tape back and see where you're at as you're laying it. So, and if you're going this, pulling it back, looking to see where your edge is at. And see how this plastic, you come in and you can push it down. If you have little holes, you just get little tiny pieces. If you pull your plastic back, if it's got a little tiny hole, just put a piece across it. So this is how we're doing this. We're doing our finished border after we tack down our plastic. I'll hurry and get this done. Probably fast forward through this so we can get onto the next window. If you're taping your border as you go, you can roll with your thumb in and tack it down. Throw it across your edge before you place it. Put your finger in there and set your plastic. So you can see how fast that window went. I put this border on here. I don't want this piece sitting on here too long after I paint it. I'm gonna pull this whole window off in one piece. When I'm doing really fast production painting, I'm painting it, I'm taking the unwrapping off it, getting it outside. So I'm showing you other ways of doing a border around it. This is my best way, my fastest way. That was super simple, super quick. We have other windows down here. And I'll go through other steps of putting those on. So give me one moment, I'll be back after I get set up. All right, second window, viewers. This is the one that I like to do if I know that I'm not gonna be able to pull off a lot of masking. I'm leaving the job overnight. The reason why you don't wanna leave the job overnight all masked up is because if you have tape right on this borderline, you come off in the morning and you have too much material on either side and you have an edge, it's not really paint prepped that well, or you know, you got too much material over the crevice and it's built up and it's not gonna pull off very easy that next day after the paint's cured. It's the biggest reason why I like to at least get my border pulled off before I leave for the end of the day and leave my paint to sit. Super important to me. If you've had problems unmasking a vehicle the next day and having your edges really messed up and having to go in with a razor blade and actually cut around your border to get your tape off, well, this prevents it. So, and say I'm doing a big old semi truck and I've got a roof panel and I've got plastic or paper, however you're masking, and you want to pull it off, well then it's prone to come off in your fresh paint. And this is why you leave these big old sheets of plastic or paper on, and this is the way you can actually pull off your fresh paint and leave it for the night. So put your hand against your panel, put the side of your razor blade the side so you don't cut nothing. When I'm putting this border on, I'm just coming like a quarter inch from the edge. I'm gonna do a border of a smaller piece of tape around this edge. When I get done painting, it's kind of tack free. Before I go, I'm just gonna pull and bundle up that tape around the edge and I'll be able to walk away. You still have to be careful if you're pulling long strips of tape that they don't come and fall and stick right to your paint. So anyways, pull your plastic or your paper away and do your cut. Come in here with your border. Masking job doesn't have to look good. It just has to serve its purpose. Especially if you're in a production line, you're trying to impress someone with your beautiful masking job and you're wasting time trying to do it. Then really, how useful really is it? You're not making much money doing that. So anyways, I got this border around it like that. Now I've got a smaller piece of tape and I'm going to go around this border and that, and go to your edge. When you're masking, hold the roll like this. Don't ever hold it like this. You'll stretch your line. So there, you don't want to over mask and get on this panel. You see that little tiny thin line right there? Just enough where it's sitting off of your panel that you're painting. If you do, say, over mask, like I just did right there, then you can come in and trim that up. See how it's off the panel now? So you always want to check your edges, because if I go pulling that tape and my paint layer is bridged across it, and before the paint's even cured, you can pull all that apart. And the next day when you're pulling your tape off and you have paint that's just cured, and I mean, you're gonna have to go in there and cut that out, and then you're gonna go and have to touch it up. So if you want a good looking quality job, then your edges are super important to address. Press a little bit of it down and go back. This way does use up that little extra bit of tape, but it's a really good way. Just like every mask job that you do, you always want to make sure that all your borders are all taped up nice. You're not gonna be spraying behind it, spraying the window. Like, see this little rip that got in my plastic? For some reason, these plastics do that a lot. That's one bad thing about masking with plastic versus paper. And there's pros and cons of it, and I like to use plastic. That little piece of plastic I got off the back is just kind of extra plastic. I can use that, and it saves you time because paper's expensive. And so I like to use plastic as someone would with paper on windows and everything. I'm actually gonna mask up a window. In fact, I'm gonna mask up this window in paper. I'm gonna show, if you're using paper and you're not gonna use plastic, I'm gonna show you a good way, just like this, to use paper. So there's the second window. Now, when you're done painting, well, I'd say before you start painting, you want to pull your border. You want to unmask it the same. You want to pull it off the same way as you masked it. So all these overlap pieces, you'll pull it all off in one piece. So mask this down a little bit. This is my starting spot where I'm gonna pull this whole border off. I'm gonna fold the tape and get myself a little tab right here. So when I'm done painting, I've got plastic, or I've got rubber gloves on, and I'm sitting here trying to peel up tape that has paint on it. Well, I don't have to worry about it. I got enough here. And I can just slowly go like that with my gloves on, even if I have really fresh tape and ball or fresh paint, and just ball it up as I go. Pull that border off. Go home for the night. Let the paint dry. I use this a lot. Obviously, this is, if I can get away with it and I can pull this big sheet off, and I'm not gonna screw up my project. That's the fastest way with less tape. This is the second fastest way. And my favorite, I put a border around anything if I can and pull it off before I leave. Anyways, I've gone through that enough. So now we're gonna go to, I'm gonna save this window for last. This one's gonna be the generic masking window that a lot of people do. Pros and cons about it. I don't really see a lot of pros, but so anyways, now we're gonna go this window, but we're gonna use paper the same way, but I'm gonna show you a trick with paper that's super awesome. I love it. I did it for lots of years before I started laying plastic down with everything. Oh, plastic. You gotta lay this plastic on the right way. On the edge of your plastic, on it says paint on this side. Make sure that you can read the letters paint on this side, and you paint on the side that it says paint on this side. If you don't, as you're spraying across here, your paint's gonna be flaking off and pulling off, and you're gonna have a huge issue. So let me go get my paper, and I'll be back. All right, we got our piece of paper hanging. It's a crappy piece of paper. It likes to roll and fold on you. Can't work with very well. That's okay. Everybody uses it. So, this is the trick to it. You get your fingernail, and with paper, this is your outside border of where you're masking. You pull your tape back. You can sit here and make an impression on this paper. Paper impression. Impression, and just press it on the edge with your fingernails. Just like that. So now you know your border. You pull it back. This is really pretty cool. This is what I do like about paper, because I can use a smaller masking tape. I can actually come in here if I want to just do one border like I did this window. I actually pull this away from the panel. That way I'm not cutting to my sides, and actually make a really nice clean cut right around this border. I do love paper this way. You can mask super fast with paper this way. Super fast. Paper's expensive. And so, you know, if I can get away with using plastic instead of paper and saving on paper, then I'm going to. Especially if I can mask it about the same quickness. So now, you know, you can tack this down. Paper, it don't like to lay flat. Plastic's kind of a pain in the butt too. So anyways, if you want to just go around with a nice border, just tack your paper down. That way it's not moving in and out on you, and you're trying to lay down a nice border, one border around it. You're just gonna pull this whole piece of paper with your border off right after you get done painting it. You don't have a border or nothing, you're just pulling it off like I did to this window. Just tack it down. That way it saves you time when you're laying down your border. See this? See how nice and crisp? See how that edge falls right into there? I mean, you get smaller tape, it's cheaper. If you can mask like this on everything, I mean, you do. I mean, tape's expensive. This, with plastic, it's harder to be this precise with plastic. Unless you're doing it the way that we're gonna show you on that other window. And you can actually do it this way with smaller tape back there. We'll get to that. Let's just finish masking this up real quick. See how I put my tape down? I got it sticky side out. It's a lot better than starting and stopping. I always like to pull my tape back like this too. Lay a little bit down. That way I can see where I'm going, even if I'm... Seems like I do that quite often. Seems like it helps me out quite a bit. See, this kind of stuff you get with plastic. This is the trick that you want to know about if you want to pull a border off or whatever. We'll just do it here. Put a tab there. That's where you pull from. Get your borders all laid down. Make sure there's no holes. I mean, that's easy, quick, fast masking on this trailer. Saves you a bunch of time, money. Customers are happy because you're not spending as much time on it. If you're hourly like my shop is and you're just getting through the job as quick as you can, they're paying the bill after. Well, you gotta know what you're doing to charge like that. All right, let's go to that other window. I'll be back. Does this look familiar? How many of you just go in and grab a roll and just start making a border around everything you're painting? Do a border first. You wanna know why? Because they want you to get a razor blade and cut on this tape. They want you to cut on that tape. So this is a layer that you put down so you don't scratch your parts. When I first, back in 99 when I started out, this is the way that I got taught. And trust me, to get a very sharp razor blade to cut through the paper perfectly, a paper that you can't even see behind, without cutting this, and you're cutting through this tape, and or this paper, and you're not cutting through the tape, it's an art. It's hard to do. Teaching someone how to mask this way when they never use a razor blade is ridiculous. We shouldn't do that. If you're gonna be doing it this way and you want to put a border around this, this is what you do. If you're not familiar with the razor blade and you can't cut through a piece of tape or paper and not through your tape, you know how many different, you know how many parts? Back in 1999, I was 13 years old. My summers were learning how to mask, learning how to prep, learning how to prime, watching my instructor do a lot of work, and him coming by and grabbing all my masking and starting over. So this is what they want you to do. They want you to come through here and barely make a score in this paper, the very sharp razor blade, without cutting through the tape. It can be done. Don't put it in someone that's never used a razor blade. Don't put it in their hands and try to teach them how to do it. This is a better way. You can't even see through here, and then you're wanting to put your finger right on this edge and then put your razor blade along there. And that's how I got taught, was use my finger on my edge, put my razor blade inside and cut through the paper and not through the tape. Well, I've ruined a lot of moldings when I was younger. Okay, and guess what? I've got very good at not ruining moldings. After 10 years of doing it that way, I got really good at it. Let's not waste 10 years with you people learning how to do stuff. Look at this. Look at that. Pull it away. See how I just put it in imprint? Pull it away, put your hand in here. You can seriously come by here, make a really nice cut. If you're using paper, and you're gonna put a border and then another border, and this is what you do. You see how I reuse paper? Okay, I pulled this off of that back window. Paper's expensive. I do use as much of that paper as I possibly can. I even save big sheets of paper and use it in priming. See this roll right here? You know how long I've had this roll? You go look at a roll of this, and go look at a roll of plastic. I think they're about the same price. There's a lot more plastic. About the same price, and there's a lot more plastic than there is paper in that roll. So I use plastic. So, cut it this way. If you're doing your border, come around here. Finish up your nice clean border, just like that. That's awesome. Everybody can live with this, right? This is nice, it's firm, it's tight. When you spray, nothing's coming up. Well, what's wrong with taping it this way? I'll tell you what's wrong with it. You have to take off all this masking tape and paper on a fresh, cleaned panel. There's no border to pull. If you try to pull this, you're pulling everything off. My instructor from the beginning did not teach me how to do borders like this. He taped on the inside. He wanted me to go around just like this, and we put a border around it so we could pull just the border off before we left. So yeah, so when I'm over here, when I was first beginning, just rewind and go back so I don't miss anything out, so you're not getting confused. I put my fingers on the side as a guide with my razor blade. This is when I was 13 years old, and I'm trying to cut through the tape, or through the paper, and not cut through the tape. And I want to bring it in enough to where I can just tape out close to the edge so we can put a border. So you think about how much tape you're putting into this. You're putting two borders, and then you're going around the whole piece with another, so you're going three times. You're using three rolls of tape instead of one. Or if you're tacking, you can use two anyways. So there's pros and cons. So, like I'll show you here. Say, and I'm not gonna blindly cut through the paper because we got away from that. Oh, I just dropped my razor blade. So we got away from that. We don't do that with paper anymore. We're gonna mask this top window with plastic, and I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna show you if you are going to cut through material onto the tape. Only use plastic if you're gonna actually just blindly cut, because you can see through it. So, this is what we did when I began. You know, I'd come in here, I'd try not to cut the molding, and try not to cut through the tape. You know, then we'd come back in here and mask right out to this edge, put this border down, and then we'd go with another border around the edge for a pullout. Then we'd leave it all masked up. Okay, this way is so generic. Everybody does this. And I'm really glad that my instructor taught me this border right off the bat, because obviously my instructor through the years done it this way painted across here, had a lot of material, let it sit overnight. He come back the next morning and he had too much material on the edge. And then he had to go in with a razor blade, and I see it in every shop I'm at, they do it this way. I've hardly seen a border around anything, I swear we're the only ones that do it. And they have to go in there and cut. They're clear, they have to try to cut to get all this paper off, and it takes so much time. So anyways, there you go. Put a border around it, or if you can pull it off when you're done without it flapping against your panel, then there you go. So let's do some plastic up here. Let's do some plastic. Let me go grab my plastic, one sec. All right, we're doing plastic. See this? Now, I don't know Spanish, but I know this says paint this side. You know, this is English up here. See how I'm painting on this side? If you don't do this, you're gonna have a lot of problems. So this one right here, if you're gonna be using tape to cut on, then use plastic. Unless you put the indent on there anyways. So trust me, it takes a really sharp razor blade to cut through plastic to get it to pull apart. You cannot do that with a dull razor blade. And look, see how I did not cut through that tape? Well, you're barely touching that plastic. And when you're learning how to use a razor blade, that's the hardest thing to try to figure out, is how not to cut through that tape and only cut through the plastic. You see how I like to tack things down? I really do, I tack, and then I tape, because it holds everything into place. And that's what works best for me. So I'm not trying to, like I said, you know, a masking job don't have to look pretty. It's just got to serve its purpose. So that's how that is. If you want to do it that way, if you're still using plastic and you don't want to cut through the plastic and you still want to cut around your border, well, use your hand against your panel, put your razor blade just right out on the edge. You want to pull this plastic tight, and you want your razor blade. See how I'm like this far up off the panel. I have my razor blade to the side, and I'm just running it across. That's a safe way. It's just like putting your finger, making an impression on it, coming back in, pulling it off away from your panel and cutting around the edge. So the way that I'm doing it right at this second is the way that I do it on everything. But so there you go. Now you know a bunch of different ways to mask. And you want to know what? A lot of painters don't like painting on this plastic. It moves around a lot. Well, it works really well. You get through your mask job a lot faster. You get to painting a lot quicker. But a lot of people would even go around here like a 6-inch tape, paper border, and put paper across here using another border of tape around the paper, taping the paper back, sealing off the other edge is more tape. So you're using 3 times, 4 times as much tape and paper and materials the job even requires. So if you're gonna use paper like that, you know, tack it up, put a crease around it, carefully cut around it, put a border around it, put another border around all the way out to your edge. Anyways, these are the ways that you... I hope this was useful for you. I want to show you real quick. If you're doing a roof up here, where you're doing a big panel, and you don't want to sit and pull and tack, it's not necessary. You just want to get your plastic laid across the top, find out your very edge, and just tape this edge all the way down, and then pull it all the way across. After you pull it all the way across, you stretch it out, and you find your border, then you just want to put one piece of border around here. You use one piece of tape on this. And as you do it, you're pulling your plastic up and you're cutting, you know, that far in. And you're just cutting a foot, foot and a half section, 2 feet, however much you can. And then you're just putting a piece of tape down. Then you move down another 2 feet. You cut and tape, cut and tape, cut and tape. Cut and tape. Hey, I'm back on that last technique that I showed you on the roof. I'm just gonna briefly show you what I'm talking about. As you're taping as you go, you're going out to your border. Well, this is what you're doing. You're kind of tacking it, going all the way out to your border and taping it as you go. Go to the outside of your border. And so you sit there. Oh, look, I got that little edge. See? You cut a little bit. It's super messy. It's just showing you the basic of it. Just tape it in sections like that as you go. So this is just taping and as you go. Cutting and taping as you go, that's all this is. You got a big old side panel, you gotta cover it, you gotta put a border around it, you hang it up the top. Come and just cut and tape it as you go. Just go right out your outside border. Just like that. Pull your plastic into it. Just like that. So this is the fastest technique that you can do. When you're not experienced taping, you want to do it in just little sections. Mask out to your edge. Concentrate on sitting out on your edge. Come back in. So. Quickest technique. Especially if you're just learning how to mask. I ran out of tape. I gotta get some big tape. And you just mask it off in sections. Trim it, tape it, trim it, tape it, trim it, tape, trim tape, trim tape. We're trimming and taping. I trimmed all the way down here. Look at this technique. You pull your plastic tight and you tack it down. Tight right there. Trim a little bit. If you're fixing all this as you go, you know it's taken care of. When you're working with big panels, this is what you do. Trim it. Take a piece off. Hit your edge. And this is for kind of people that have never really masked before. If you want to be quick at masking and not spend days and days masking, take a little tiny piece off after you trim it. Go to your edge. Lay your edge down just a little bit at a time. Use big tape. Don't really waste your time going across that a few times. Especially if you're not able to make a really nice crisp line. If you have more of a footprint on your tape on the sides, it's not gonna be coming off as easy when you're painting. You got an edge right there, push it in it, and then get your razor blade, and then go through and trim it out. That's a good way of masking. A little razor blade, you can make a nice edge with the razor blade. Or you can put your tape up to it. Cut with the razor blade that way. The more simplified you can do your projects, the funner the project is to work on. You don't want nothing fighting you. You want to do it as simple as possible. Well, these are very simple just to go through and tape up. Plastic versus paper. Plastic is awesome to use anywhere. It's definitely a lot cheaper than paper. But if I try putting plastic down in here, this is where plastic gets its bad name. An extra panel and you're painting, well, this is gonna start sticking to your panel. So, you know, you still wanna use plastic to cover up the rest of it, because you don't want to sit there and try to bundle paper around all that, and it'd be so expensive to use paper. So tie this plastic down, you know, pretty tight, and we'll tie the plastic back, you know, better. We'll wrap it up that way we're not painting over here. This can be loose. But right here now, we still want to cover those batteries, so we're going to get some paper and lay down in there. This is where you use paper. See this plastic? All this stuff has to be either taped down the floor, tied back, or it's going to come back and get up into your paint job. This is where plastic gets its bad name, floating around, jumping into projects. Well, you got that. Like you said, we're gonna do plastic up to our panel, and then we're gonna put paper down. I walk the line. Where's my paper? As sure as night is dark and day is light. This is where we use paper. You don't have it sitting on your masking machine, you need to put a piece of tape on it. We'll just lay it out across here. Put a piece of tape on it. Pull it back. You've got a baby to keep me on your side. You give me calls for love that I can't. Good thing about this paper, why we like to do this, we can pull that paper tight. And it's gonna stay there as we're painting. Won't have to worry about it moving around. Paper does not move around like plastic does. I got this little wind burst coming through here, just causing me problems. Well, I'm just gonna start tying this plastic down. So it don't move. However, we do not want this plastic coming, getting into our paint job. Thank you. this is a lot of tape to put in that area. Sometimes it's necessary. If it's quicker to do it that way, well, sometimes saving your time, time's money, most of the time. You can get down here, tie this plastic up too. Cut this tail off, tape it back. Make sure that's not getting in your paint. You don't have to seal this off with tape. And the plastic's so far underneath there, it's not gonna get to it. Tape, I don't really like a whole lot. Super brittle. That's what the customer brought me. She's my sister and a baby. She's my